Ευλογημένη η Βασιλεία του Πατρός και του Υιού και του Αγίου Πνεύματος, νυν και αεί και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων.
Αμήν.
Come, let us worship and bow down to God our King. Come, let us worship and bow down to Christ our King and God. Come, let us worship and bow down to Christ himself, our King and God. Bless the Lord, O my soul. O Lord God, you are great indeed, clothed in honor and splendor, wearing light as a cloak, stretching out the sky as a tent cloth, establishing your lofty halls on water. You make the clouds your conveyance, you surge on the wings of the wind. You make the winds your messengers, and the flaming fires your attendants. You settled the earth on its foundation. It shall stand unmoved from age to age. The deep covered it like a garment. The waters stood above the mountains. At your rebuke, they took to flight. At the peal of your thunder, they fled. They hurtle the hills and run down the dales to the place you have chosen for them. You have set up a boundary not to be passed. They shall never return to cover the earth. Down in the gullies, you make springs to rise. Waters shall flow between the mountains. They shall give drink to the beasts of the field. Wild asses will seek them to quench their thirst. The birds of the sky will abide by them, for among the rocks they will raise their song. From your lofty halls you refresh the hills. The earth shall be fed with the fruit of your works. You make green pastures for the cattle and food plants for the service of men, so that bread may be brought forth from the earth, and wind that gladdens the heart of man, so that oil may be put agleam upon his face, and that bread may strengthen the heart of man. The trees of the plain shall be satisfied, the cedars of Lebanon that he planted. The sparrows will build their nests in them, and the herons will call them their home. To the deer belong the high mountains, to rodents the shelter of rock. You have made the moon to mark the seasons. The sun knows the time of its setting. You establish darkness, and in it night wherein the forest creatures prowl. Young lions roar for their prey and call out to God for their meat. As the sun rises, they will come together and lay themselves down in their dens. Man will go out to his labor and work until eventide. How great you are your works, O Lord. In wisdom you have wrought them all. The earth is filled with your creatures, even the wide and open sea itself. Within it are countless creeping things, living beings small and large. Upon it there are ships sailing, and the great beasts you made to have fun. All of them look upon you to give them their food in due time. You provide and they gather up. You open your hands and they are full. You hide your face and they cringe. You suspend their breath and they die and return to their dust. You send forth your breath, and they live. You renew the face of the earth. May the Lord God, may the Lord's glory endure forever. May the Lord rejoice in his works. He looks upon the earth and makes it quake. He touches the mountains, and they smoke. I will sing to the Lord as long as I live. I will praise my God as long as I last. Would that my thoughts be pleasing to him, and with rejoice, and I will rejoice in the Lord. May the sinners vanish from the earth, and the wicked be no more. Bless the Lord, O my soul.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and always, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Glory to you, O God. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Glory to you, O God. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Glory to you, O God. Our hope, O Lord, glory to you.
Και τη σωτηρία των ψυχών ημών του Κυρίου Δεϊθωμέν.
Κύριε ελεήσον.
Υπέ της ειρήνης του σύμπαντος κόσμου, ευσταθίας των Αγίων του Θεού Εκκλησιών και της των πάντρων όσεως του Κυρίου Δεϊθωμέν.
Κύριε ελεήσον.
Υπέ του Αγίου οίκου τούτου και μετά πίστεως ευλαβίας και φόβου Θεού ησιόντων εν αυτό του Κυρίου δεήθωμε.
Κύριε ελέησον.
Υπέ του Αρχιεπισκόπου και Πατρός ημών Δημητρίου του Τιμίου Πρεσβυτέριου της εν Χριστώ Διακονίας πάντως του κλήρου και του λαού του Κυρίου δεήθωμε.
Κύριε ελέησον.
For our country, the president and all in public service, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this city and parish, for every city and land, and for the faithful who live in them, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For temperate weather and abundance of the goods of the earth, and for peaceful times, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For those who travel by land, sea, and air, for those who are sick or suffering or in captivity, and for their safekeeping, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
That we may be spared all affliction, wrath, danger, and want, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Αντιλαβούς όσον ελέησον και διαφυλάξον ημάς ο Θεός της η χάριτη.
Κύριε ελέησον.
Εις Παναγίας ακράντο υπερευλοημένης εν δόξου της Χριστού Θεοτόκες
όσον ημών. Μετά πάντων των Αγίων
μονέσσονται σε αυτούς και αλλήλους και πάσαν την ζωήν ημών. Χριστό το Θεό παραθωμεθά.
Συ Κύριε.
Ότι πρέπει συ πάσα δόξα, τιμή και προσκυνήσεις, το Πατρί και το Υιό και το Άγιο Πνεύμα την ίν και αΐ, και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων.
Ξάσι Κύριε, Κύριε, εις άκουσον της φωνής μου, τα
ας εσπέρι να συμμονευχάς, πρόσθεξε Άγιε Κύριε, και παρασκούει μην άφεσιν αμαρτιών, ότι μόνος η οδήξας εν κόσμο την Ανάσταση.
Εάν ανομίας παρατηρήσεις, Κύριε, Κύριε, της υποστήσετε ότι παρασύ ο ηλασμός εστίν, encircle Zion, O you people, encompass her round about, and they give glory to him who is risen from the dead. For he is our God who has delivered us from our iniquities.
For your name's sake, O Lord, I have waited for you. My soul has waited for your promise. My soul has hoped in the Lord. Come, you people, let us praise and worship Christ, glorifying his resurrection from the dead. For he is our God who has delivered us from the deceit of the enemy.
Από φυλακής προείας μέχρι νυχτός, από φυλακής προείας έπεισα το Ισραήλ επί τον Κύριο σήμερα.
Το πάθη σου, Χριστέ, παθών ηλευθερωθήμε, και τη Ανάστασή σου εκφοράς ελυτρωθήμων, Κύριε, δόξα εσύ. Νυπαβουπανή, ότι παρά του Κυρίου το έλεος και πολύ παρά αυτό λύτρωσεις, και αυτός λυτρώσεται τον Ισραήλ εκ πασών των ανομιών αυτού. Σήμερον ο αδισθένο, εκ Μαρίας γεννηθέντα, μη υπεδεξάμην εθόν χαρεπέμε, το κράτος μου έλυσε. Πύλας χαλκάς συνέτριψε, ψυχάς ασκατήχοντον πριν, Θεός ανανέστησε. Δόξα, Κύριε, το Σταυρό σου και τη Ανάστασή σου.
Ότι παρά το ενείτε τον Κύριον πάντα τα έθνη, επενέσατε αυτόν πάντες οι λαοί. Σήμερον ο αδισθένων βοά κατελήθη μου εξ Ιησουσία. Εδεξαμνηθήτων ως τερένα των θαθνέτων τούτων δε κατέχθη. και τη Ανάστασή σου.
For mighty is his love for us, and the truth of the Lord endures forever. Today Hades lets out a groan, my might is swallowed up. The shepherd was crucified, but raised up Adam. All I ruled over I have lost, all I was able in my power to consume I have disgorged. The crucified one has emptied the graves. The sway of death is no more. Glory, Lord, to your cross and to your resurrection.
Kingdom.
with her as our anchor in the faith. We have as champion the Lord born of her. Take courage then, people of God. Be of good cheer as he, and as he, as the Almighty One, will vanquish your enemies.
Sophia, Orthi, Forsila,
created the heavens and the earth. The earth was without form and void, and darkness was upon the face of the deep. And the Spirit of God was moving over the face of the waters. And God said, "Let there be light," and there was light. And God saw that the light was good, and God separated the light from the darkness. God called the light day, and the darkness he called night. And there was evening, and there was morning, one day. And God said, "Let there be a firmament in the midst of the waters, and let it separate the waters from the waters." And God made the firmament and separated the waters which were under the firmament from the waters which were above the firmament. And it was so. And God called the firmament heaven. And there was evening and there was morning a second day. And God said, "Let the waters under the heavens be gathered together in one place, and let the dry land appear." And it was so. God called the dry land earth, and the waters that were gathered together he called seas. And God saw that it was good. And God said, "Let the earth put forth vegetation, plants yielding seed, and fruit trees bearing fruit in which kind is their seed, each according to its kind, upon the earth." And it was so. The earth brought forth vegetation, plants yielding seed according to their own kinds, and trees bearing fruit in which is their seed, each according to its kind. And God saw that it was good, and there was evening and there was morning a third day.
The reading is from the prophecy of Jonah.
Wisdom, let us be attentive.
Now Now the word of the Lord came to Jonah, the son of Amittai, saying, Arise, go to Nineveh, that great city, and cry against it, for their wickedness has come up before me. But Jonah rose to flee to Tarshish from the presence of the Lord. He went down to Joppa and found a ship going to Tarshish. So he paid the fare and went on board to go with them to Tarshish, away from the presence of the Lord. But the Lord hurled a great wind upon the sea, and there was a mighty tempest on the sea. So the ship threatened to break up. Then the mariners were afraid, and each cried to his God. And they threw the wares that were in the ship into the sea to lighten it for them. But Jonah had gone down into the inner part of the ship and had lain down and was fast asleep. So the captain came and said to him, What do you mean, you sleeper? Arise, call upon your God. Perhaps the God will give a thought to us, and that we do not perish. And they said to one another, Come, let us cast lots, and we may know on whose account the evil has come upon us. So they cast lots, and the lot fell upon Jonah. Then they said to him, Tell us, on whose account this evil has come upon us? What is your occupation, and whence do you come? What is your country, and of what people are you? And he said to them, I am a Hebrew, and I fear the Lord, the God of heaven, who made the sea and the dry land. Then the men were exceedingly afraid and said to him, What is it that you have done? For the men knew he was fleeing from the presence of the Lord, because he had told them. Then they said to him, What shall we do to you that the sea may quiet down for us? For the sea grew more and more tempestuous. He said to them, Take me up and throw me into the sea. Then the sea will quiet down for you. For I know it is because of me that this great tempest has come upon you. Nevertheless, the men rowed hard to bring the ship back to the land, but they could not, for the sea grew more and more tempestuous against them. Therefore they cried to the Lord, We beseech thee, O Lord, let us not perish for this man's life, and lay not us on us innocent blood. For thou, O Lord, hast done as it pleased to thee. So they took up Jonah and threw him into the sea, and the sea ceased from its raging. Then the men feared the Lord exceedingly, and they offered a sacrifice to the Lord and made vows. Then Jonah prayed to the Lord for his God from the belly of the fish, saying, I called to the Lord out of my distress, and he answered me. Out of the belly of Sheol I cried, and that thou didst hear my voice, for thou didst cast me into the deep, into the heart of the seas, and the flood was round me. All thy waves and thy billows passed over me. Then I said, I am cast out from the presence. How shall I again look upon the holy temple? The waters closed over me, and the deep was around me. Weeds were wrapped about my head at the roots of the mountains. I went down to the land whose bars closed upon me forever. Yet thou didst bring up my life from the pit, O Lord my God. When my soul fainted within me, I remembered the Lord, and my prayer came to thee, into the holy temple. Those who pay regard to vain idols forsake their true loyalty. But I, with the voice of thanksgiving, will sacrifice to thee. What I have vowed, I will pay. Deliverance belongs to the Lord. And the Lord spoke to the fish, and it vomited out Jonah upon the dry land. Then the word of the Lord came to Jonah the second time, saying, Arise, go to Nineveh, the great city, and proclaim to it the message I tell you. So Jonah arose and went to Nineveh, according to the word of the Lord. Now Nineveh was an exceedingly great place, 3 days' journey in breadth. Jonah began to go to the city, going a day's journey. And he cried, Yet 40 days, and Nineveh shall be overthrown. And the people of Nineveh believed in God. They proclaimed a fast and put a sackcloth from the greatest of them to the least of them.
Then tidings reached the king of Nineveh, and he arose from his throne, removed his robe, and covered himself with sackcloth, and sat in ashes. And he made proclamation and published through Nineveh, By the decree of the king and his nobles, let neither man nor beast, herd nor flock, taste anything. Let them not feed or drink water, but let man and beast be covered with sackcloth, and let them cry mightily to God. Yes, let everyone turn from his evil way and from the violence which is in his hands. Who knows, God may yet repent and turn from his fierce anger so that we perish not. When God saw that they did, how they turned from their evil way, God repented of the evil which he had said he would do to them, and he did not do it. But it displeased Jonah exceedingly, and he was angry. And he prayed to the Lord and said, I pray thee, Lord, is not this what I said when I was yet in my country? That is why I made haste to flee to Tarshish, for I knew that thou art a gracious God and merciful, slow to anger and abounding in steadfast love, and repentest of evil. Therefore now, O Lord, take my life from me, I beseech thee, for it is better for me to die than to live. And the Lord said, Do you do well to be angry? Then Jonah went out of the city and sat to the east of the city and made a booth for himself there. He sat under it in the shade till he should see what would become of the city. And the Lord God appointed a plant and made it come up over Jonah that it might be a shade over his head to save him from his discomfort. So Jonah was exceedingly glad because of the plant. But when dawn came up the next day, God appointed a worm which attacked the plant so that it withered. When the sun rose, God appointed a sultry east wind, and the sun beat upon the head of Jonah so that he was faint. And he asked that he might die and said, It is better for me to die than to live. But God said to Jonah, Do you do well to be angry for the plant? And he said, I do well to be angry, angry enough to die. And the Lord said, You pity the plant for which you did not labor, nor did you make it grow, which came into being in a night and perished in a night. And should not I pity Nineveh, that great city, in which there are more than 120,000 persons who do not know their right hand from their left, and also much cattle?
The reading is from the prophecy of Daniel.
Wisdom, let us be attentive.
King Nebuchadnezzar made an image of gold whose height was 60 cubits and its breadth 6 cubits. He set it up in the plain of Dura in the province of Babylon. Then King Nebuchadnezzar sent to assemble the satraps and the prefects and the governors and the counselors and the treasurers, the justices, the magistrates, and all the officials of the provinces to come to the dedication of the image which King Nebuchadnezzar had set up. Then the satraps, the prefects, the governors, the counselors, the treasurers, the justices, the magistrates, and all the officials of the provinces were assembled for the dedication of the image that King Nebuchadnezzar had set up. And they stood before the image that Nebuchadnezzar had set up. And the herald proclaimed aloud, You are commanded, O peoples, nations, and languages, that when you hear the sound of the horn, pipe, lyre, trigon, harp, bagpipe, and every kind of music, that you are to fall down and worship the golden image that King Nebuchadnezzar has set up. And whoever does not fall down and worship shall immediately be cast into a burning fiery furnace. Therefore, as soon as all the peoples heard the sound of the horn, pipe, lyre, trigon, harp, bagpipe, and every kind of music, all peoples, nations, and languages fell down and worshiped the golden image which King Nebuchadnezzar had set up. Therefore, at the time, certain Chaldeans came forward and maliciously accused the Jews. They said to King Nebuchadnezzar, O king, live forever. You, O king, have made a decree that every man who hears the sound of the horn, pipe, lyre, trigon, harp, bagpipe, and every kind of music shall fall down and worship the golden image, and whoever does not fall down and worship shall be cast into a burning fiery furnace. And there are certain Jews whom you have appointed over the affairs of the province of Babylon, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. These men, O king, pay no heed to you. They do not serve your gods or worship the golden image which you have set up. Then Nebuchadnezzar, in furious rage, commanded that Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego be brought. Then they brought these men before the king. Nebuchadnezzar said to them, Is it true, O Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, that you do not serve my gods or worship the golden image which I have set up? Now, if you are ready when you hear the sound of the horn, pipe, lyre, trigon, harp, bagpipe, and every kind of music to fall down and worship the image which I have made, well and good. But if you do not worship, you shall be immediately cast into the burning fiery furnace. And who is the God that will deliver you out of my hands? Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego answered the king, O Nebuchadnezzar, we have no need to answer you in this matter. If it be so, our God, whom we serve, is able to deliver us from the burning fiery furnace, and he will deliver us out of your hand, O king. But if not, be it known to you, O king, that we will not serve your gods or worship the golden image which you have set up. Then Nebuchadnezzar was full of fury, and the expression of his face was changed against Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. He ordered the furnace be heated seven times more than it was wont to be heated, and he ordered certain mighty men of his army to bind Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, and to cast them into the burning fiery furnace. Then these men were bound in their mantles, their tunics, their hats, and their other garments, and they were cast into the burning fiery furnace. Because the king's orders were strict and the furnace very hot, the flame of the fire slew those men who took up Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. And these three men, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, fell bound into the fiery furnace. And they walked into the midst of the flame, praising God and blessing the Lord. Then Azarias stood and offered this prayer. In the midst of the fire, he opened his mouth and said,
Blessed are you, O Lord, God of our fathers, and worthy of praise. And your name is glorified forever. You are just in all that you have done to us. And all your works are true, and your ways right. And all your judgments are true. You have executed true judgments in all that you have brought upon us and upon Jerusalem, the holy city of our fathers. For in truth and justice you have brought all this upon us because of our sins. For we have sinfully and lawlessly departed from you, and have sinned in all things, and have not obeyed your commandments. We have not observed them or done them, and as you have commanded us, that it might go well with us. So that all you have brought upon us, and all that you have done to us, you have done in true judgment. You have given us into the hands of lawless enemies, most hated rebels, and to an unjust king, the most wicked in all the world. And now we cannot open our mouths. Shame and disgust have befallen your servants and worshipers. For your name's sake, do not give us up utterly, and do not break your covenant, and do not withdraw your mercy from us, for the sake of Abraham, your beloved, and for the sake of Isaac, your servant, and Israel, your holy one, to whom you did promise to make their descendants as many as the stars of heaven and as the sand on the shore of the sea. For we, O Lord, have become fewer than any nation and are brought low this day and all the world because of our sins. And at this time there is no prince, no or prophet, or leader, no burnt offering, or sacrifice, or oblation, or incense, no place to make an offering before you or to find mercy. Yet with a contrite heart and a humble spirit may we be accepted, as though it were with burnt offerings of rams and bulls, and with tens of thousands of fat lambs. Such may our sacrifice be in your sight this day, and may we wholly follow you, for there will be no shame for those who trust in you. And now with all our heart we follow you. We fear you and seek your face. Do not put us to shame, but deal with us in your forbearance and your abundant mercy. Deliver us in accordance with your marvelous works, and give glory to your name, O Lord. Let all who do harm to your servants be put to shame, and let them be disgraced and deprived of all power and dominion, and let their strength be broken. Let them know that you are the Lord, the only God, glorious over the whole world. Now the king's servants who drew them in did not cease feeding the furnace fires with naphtha, pitch, tow, and brush. And the flame streamed above the furnace 49 cubits, and it broke through the furnace, and it broke through and burned those of the Chaldeans whom it caught about the furnace. But the angel of the Lord came down into the furnace to be with Azarias and his companions, and drove the fiery flame out of the furnace, and made the midst of the furnace like a moist whistling wind, so that the fire did not touch them at all, or hurt or trouble them. Then the three, with one mouth, praised and glorified and blessed God in the furnace, saying,
Blessed are you, O Lord, God of our fathers, and to be praised and highly exalted forever. And blessed is your glorious holy name, and to be highly praised and highly exalted forever. Blessed are you in the temple of your holy glory, and to be extolled and highly glorified forever. Blessed are you who sits upon cherubim and looks into the deeps, and the praised and highly exalted forever. Blessed are you upon the throne of your kingdom, and to be extolled and highly exalted forever. Blessed are you in the firmament of heaven, and to be sung and glorified forever.
Τον Κύριον ημνείτε και υπέρ ύψου Christus aeonos.
Praise the Lord, all the works of the Lord. Praise the Lord and exalt him to all ages.
O ye angels of the Lord and you heavens of the Lord, bless ye the Lord.
Exalt and praise the Lord forever and forever.
Τα πάντα υπεράτω των ουρανών, πάσε δυνάμεις Κυρίου των Κυρίων, των Κυρίων ημνείτε και υπεριψούτε εις πάντας τους αιώνας.
Bless the Lord, all you waters above the heavens and all powers of the Lord. Exalt and praise the Lord forever and forever.
Ευλογείτε ήλιος και σελήνη, άστρα του ουρανού, των Κυρίων. Τον Κύριον υμνείτε και υπεριψούτε εις πάντας τους αιώνας.
Bless the Lord, light and darkness, night and day.
Exalt and praise the Lord forever and forever.
Bless the Lord, showers and dew and all the winds.
Exalt and praise the Lord forever and forever. Bless the Lord, fire and warmth, cold and heat. Exalt and praise the Lord forever and forever.
Bless the Lord, dew and snow, ice and cold. Exalt and praise the Lord forever and forever.
Ευλογείτε πάχνε και χιόνες, άστραπε και νεφέλε των Κύριων. Τον Κύριον υμνείτε και υπεριψούτε εις πάντας τους αιώνας.
Bless the Lord, earth, mountains and hills, and all things that grow in it. Exalt and praise the Lord forever and forever.
Bless the Lord, mountains, seas, rivers, wells, and everything that moves in it. Exalt and praise the Lord forever and forever.
Ευλογείτε πάντα τα πετεινά του ουρανού, τα θηρία και πάντα τα κτίνη των Κυρίων. Τον Κύριον υμνείτε και υπεριψούτε εις πάντας τους αιώνας.
Bless the Lord, sons of men, bless him and let Israel bless.
Exalt and praise the Lord forever and forever.
Ευλογείτε ιερείς Κυρίου, δούλοι Κυρίου των Κυρίων. Τον Κύριον υμνείτε και υπεριψούτε εις πάντας τους αιώνας.
Bless the Lord, spirits and souls of the righteous, holy and humble men of heart. Exalt and praise the Lord forever and forever.
Bless the Lord, Ananias, Azarias, and Mishael. Exalt and praise the Lord forever and forever.
Ευλογείτε Απόστολοι, προφήτε και μάρτυρες Κυρίου των Κυρίων. Τον Κύριον υμνείτε και υπεριψούτε εις πάντας τους αιώνας.
Bless the Lord, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Προσκυνούμεν τον Κύριον, τον Κύριον υμνούμεν και υπεριψούμεν εις πάντας τους αιώνας.
εσύ την δόξα να αναπέμπομεν, το Πατρί και το Υιό και το Άγιο Πνεύμα την ίν και αΐ και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων.
Αμήν. Ως εις Χριστόν ευαπτίστητε, Χριστόν ενεδίσαστε.
Let them sing to your name.
Wisdom.
The reading is from the letter of the Holy Apostle Paul to the Romans.
Let us be attentive.
Brethren, do you not know that all of us who have been baptized in Christ Jesus were baptized in his death? We were buried therefore with him by baptism into death, so that as Christ we raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might walk in newness of life. For if we have been united with him in a death like his, we shall certainly be united with him in a resurrection like his. We know that our old self was crucified with him so that the sinful body might be destroyed and we might no longer be enslaved to sin. For he who has died is freed from sin. But if we have died with Christ, we believe that we shall also live with him. For we know that Christ, being raised from the dead, will never die again. Death no longer has dominion over him. The death he died to sin, once for all. But the life he lives to God. So you also must consider yourselves dead to sin and alive to God in Christ Jesus.
Assembly of the gods, and in their midst he judges the gods.
Arise,
Προσελθόν απεκύλησε τον λίθον από τη στήρα και κάθητο επάνω αυτού. Ήνδε είδε αυτού ως αστραπή και τον ένδυμαν αυτού λευκόν ως ηχιόν. Από δε του φόβου αυτού οι σύστησαν οι τηρούντες και γενετός οι νεκροί. Απεκριθήστε ο άγγελος υπέν τες γυναίξη, μη φοβήστε ημείς, είδα γαρωτήσουν των εσταυρωμένων ζητείτε, ουκ εστιν όδε, η έρθιγαρ καθώς είπε. Δεύτε είδετε τον τόπον όπου εκείνο ο Κύριος. Τεχαχή, πορευθήσε είπατε τις μαθητές αυτού, ότι έθι από τον νεκρόν. Και ειδού προάγει μας εις την Γαλιλαίαν, εκεί αυτόν όψεστε, ειδού υπον ημίν. Και εξελθούσε ταχύ από τη μημείου μεταφόβου και χαράς μεγάλης έδραμον απαγγείλει τις μαθητές αυτού. Ώστε πορεύουν το απαγγελεί τις μαθητές αυτού και ειδού Ιησούς απήντησεν αυτές λέγον χαίρετε. Ιδε προσελθούσε, εκράτησεν αυτού τους πόδας και προσεκίνησαν αυτό. Τότε λέγει αυτές ο Ιησούς, μη φοβήστε, υπάγετε, απαγγείλατε της αδελφής μου, είναι απέλθουσιν εις την Γαλιλαίαν, κακοί με όψονται. Πορευωμένον δε αυτόν ειδούτινες της κουστοδίας ελθόντες εις την πόλη να πήγηλαν της αρχιερεύσιν άπαντα τα γενόμενα. Και συνακθέντες μετά των πρεσβυτέρων συμβούλιον τελαβώντες αγύρια ικανά εδωκέν τις στρατιώτες λέγοντες. Είπατε ότι μαθητέ αυτού νυκτός ελθόντες έκλεψαν αυτόν ημών κοιμωμένον. Και αν ακουστεί τούτο επί του ηγουμένος, εμείς πείσομεν αυτόν και ημάς αμερίμνους πείσομεν. Οι δε λαβώντες τα γύρια πείσεν ως εδιδάχθησαν. Και δε μισμίστη ο λόγος ούτως παρά Ιουδαίος μέχρι της σήμερον. Οι δε ένδεκα μαθητέ επορεύθησαν εις την Γαλιλαίαν, εις το όρος σου ετάξατο αυτής ο Ιησούς. Και οι δόντες αυτόν προσεκίνησαν αυτό, οι δε δίστασαν. Και προσελθόν ο Ιησούς ελάλησεν αυτοίς λέγον, εδώ θυμή πας εξουσίαν ουρανό και πηγής, πορευθέντες μαθητεύσατε πάντα τα έθνη, βαπτίζοντες αυτούς εις το όνομα του Πατρός και του Υιού και του Αγίου Πνεύματος, διδάσκοντες αυτούς την ειν πάντα όσα εν ειτηλάμην ημίν. Και ειδού εγώ με θυμών ημι πάσας τας ημέρας έως της συντελείας του αιώνος. Amen.
The reading is from the Holy Gospel according to St. Matthew. Let us be attentive.
Glory to you, Lord. Glory to you.
After the Sabbath, toward the dawn of the first day of the week, Mary Magdalene and the other Mary went to see the sepulcher. And behold, there was a great earthquake, for an angel of the Lord descended from heaven and came and rolled back the stone and sat upon it. His appearance was like lightning, and his raiment white as snow. And for fear of him, the guards trembled and became like dead men. But the angel said to the woman, "Do not be afraid, for I know that you seek Jesus who was crucified. He is not here, for he has risen as he said. Come see the place where he lay. Then go quickly and tell his disciples that he has risen from the dead, and behold, he is going before you to Galilee. There you will see him. Lo, I have told you." So they departed quickly from the tomb with fear and great joy and ran to tell his disciples. And behold, Jesus met them and said, "Hail." And they came up and took hold of his feet and worshipped him. Then Jesus said to them, "Do not be afraid. Go and tell my brethren to go to Galilee, and there they will see me." While they were going, behold, some of the guard went into the city and told the chief priests all that had taken place. And when they had assembled with the elders and taken counsel, they gave of some money to the soldiers and said, "Tell people his disciples came by night and stole him away while you were asleep. And if this comes to the governor's ears, we will satisfy him and keep you out of trouble." So they took money and did as they were directed. And this story has been spread among the Jews to this day. Now the 11 disciples went to Galilee, to the mountain to which Jesus had directed them. And when they saw him, they worshipped him, but some doubted. And Jesus came and said to them, "All authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Go therefore and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, teaching them to observe all that I have commanded you. And lo, I am with you always, to the close of the age. Amen."
Glory to you, O Lord. Glory to you, O
Όπως υπό το κράτος σου πάντοτε φυλακτόμενοι, εσύ δόξαν αναπέμπομεν. Το Πατρί και το Υιό και το Άγιο Πνεύματι, νυν και αεί και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων.
Let all mortal beings keep silent and stand in fear and trembling, giving no thought to earthly things. For the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, comes forth to be sacrificed and given as food for the faithful. Before him go the choirs of the angels, with all the principalities and all the powers. Oh,
Πολιόματα χερούφι Pater Eius. πρόσκομεν.
Πιστεύουσαι σε ένα Θεό.
Πατέρα Παντοκράτορα, ποιητήν ουρανού και γης ορατώνται πάντων και οράτων, και εις ένα Κύριον Ιησού Χριστόν, τον Υιόν του Θεού του Μονογενή,
τον εν του Πατρός νηθέντε από πάντων των αιώνων.
Φως εκ φωτός Θεών αληθινών, εκ Θεού αληθινού, γεννήθεντα ου ποιήθεντα, ομοούς του Πατρίδου το πάντα γέρετο, τον ημάς ανθρώπους και διτιμητέρων σωτηρίων, τον δεθόν εκ του ουρανών, και σαρκωθέν εκ πνεύματος Αγίου και Μαρίας της Παρθένου και ανθρωπίσαντα, σταυρωθέντε υπέρ ημών επί Ποντίου Πιλάτου, και παθώντα και τα φέντα, και να στάντα την τρίτη ημέρα καταστραφάς, και ιερωθών εις τους ουρανούς, και καθεζόμενον δεξιόν του Πατρός, και πάλιν ερχόμενον με τα δόξης, κρίνε ζώντες και νεκρούς, ούτης βασιλείας σου και στε τέλος, και στο πνεύμα το Άγιον, το Κύριον, το Ζωοποιόν, του εκ του Πατρός εμπορευόμενον, το Συν Πατρί και Υιός υπροσκυνούμενον, και συνδοξαζόμενον το λαλήσει δια των προφητών, εις μίαν Αγίαν Καθολικήν και Αποστολικήν Εκκλησίαν, ομολογώ εν βάπτισμα εις άφεσιν αιματιών, προσεκώ ανάσταση νεκρών και ζωήν του μέλλοντος αιώνος. Αμήν.
I believe in one God, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, and of all things visible and invisible. And in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, begotten of the Father before all ages, light of light, true God of true God, begotten, not created, of one essence with the Father, through whom all things were made, who for us a man and for our salvation came down from heaven and was incarnate of the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary and became man. He was crucified for us under Pontius Pilate and suffered and was buried. And he rose on the third day according to the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. And he will come again with glory to judge the living and the dead. His kingdom shall have no end. And in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the Creator of life, proceeds from the Father, who together with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who spoke through the prophets. In one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church, I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the age to come. Amen.
Στόμεν καλός, στόμεν μετά φόβο πρόσκομεν, την Αγίαν αναφοράν, εν ειρήνη προσφέρειν.
Ελέον ειρήνης θυσίαν ενεσεώς.
Η χάρις του Κυρίου ημών Ιησού Χριστού και αγάπη του Θεού και Πατρός και η κοινωνία του Αγίου Πνεύματος ή με τα πάντων ημών.
Και με τα του Πνεύματος σου.
Ανάσχομεν τας καρδίας, let us lift up our hearts to the Lord.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Ευχαριστήσομεν το Κυρίο.
Αξιών και δικαίων.
This is our spiritual worship. For you have given us grace to know your truth. Who could so much as speak of your lordship or sing you due praises on recount of your countless wonders through the ages? Master of all, Lord of heaven and earth and of all creation, seen and unseen, you are enthroned upon a seat of glory, able to plumb the depths, eternal, invisible, beyond comprehending or describing, unchanging, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, the great God and Savior, the object of our hope. For he is the image of your goodness, the seal bearing your perfect likeness, revealing you as Father through himself. He is the living Word, true God, wisdom beyond the ages, life, sanctification, power, the true light. Through him the Holy Spirit was made manifest, the Spirit of truth, the gift of adoption, the foretaste of the future inheritance, the first fruits of eternal blessing, the life-giving power, the fountainhead of holiness. Empowered by him, every rational and intelligent being sings ceaselessly of your glory. For all serve you, it is you the angels and archangels adore, the thrones and dominions, the principalities, the virtues, the powers, and the cherubim with many eyes. It is you the seraphim encircle, each with six wings. With the two they cover their faces, with the two their feet, and flying with the two they cry out to one another with ceaseless voices and perpetual praise, singing, proclaiming, shouting the victory hymn, and saying, Τον επινίκιον ύμνον άδοντα, βόντα και κραγότα και λέγοντα. With these blessed powers, saying, Εδώ και τη Αγία αυτού μαθητέ και Αποστόλη υπόν. Λάβετε, φάγετε, τούτου μου εστί το σώμα του υπερήμων κλωμένων. Εις άφεσιν αμαρτιών. Take, eat, this is my body, which is broken for you for the forgiveness of sins.
Likewise, taking the cup of food, divine, mixing it, giving thanks,
blessing and sanctifying it, he gave it to his holy disciples and apostles, saying, Εδώ και τις αείς αυτού μαθητές και αποστόλης υπόν. Πίετε εξ αυτού πάντες, τούτου εστί το αίμα μου, το της καινής διαθήκης, το υπερήμων και πολλών εχινόμενων, εις άφεσιν αμαρτιών. Drink of it, all of you, this is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins.
Oh,
do this in the manifest my resurrection. Therefore, Master, as we too remember his saving sufferings, the life-giving cross, the 3 days in the tomb, the resurrection from the dead, the ascension into heaven, the enthronement at your right hand, God and Father, in his glorious and awesome second coming, O Theos, last matalo, keleison.
Tasa ekton son, si prosferomen, kata panda ke dia panda.
Precious body of our Lord God and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. And this cup, the precious blood of our Lord God and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. The shed for the life and the redemption of the world. Amen. As for all of us partaking of the one bread and cup, unite us to one another in the communion of the one Holy Spirit.
Εξαιρέτως της Παναγίας Ακράντο υπερευλοημένης, εν δόξου δεσποινησιμών Θεοτόκου και αη Παρθένου Μαρία.
Υπόβου φωνή, επισηχαίρι και χαριτωμένη πάσα εκτήσεις αγγέλων σύστημα και ανθρώπων το γένος, υγειασμένη να και παράδεισε λογικέ παρθενικών καυχημά. Εξης Θεός σαρκώθηκε παιδίων και γονέν, ο προαιώνων υπάρχουν Θεός ημών. Την γαρσιν μήτραν θρόνων επίσε και την σύν γαστέρα πλατιτέρα ουρανών απήργασα το επισηχέρι και χαριτωμένη πάσα εκτήσιν δόξα ασύ. In you the one who is full of grace, all creation rejoices, the hierarchy of ages and the human race. Hallowed temple, spiritual glory to you. Be mindful, Lord,
anyone, whether out of ignorance or forgetfulness, or because of the great number of names, you, O God, remember.
Σον εν δημονιά μου κρεύοντα, καθοδουλούντα το λόγο της εις αληθείας.
Also remember, Lord, those whom each of us calls to mind, and all your people.
And all your people.
Remember my unworthy person, forgive my every transgression, voluntary and involuntary. Do not allow my sins to block the vision of this spirit. Of nations, by the might of your Holy Spirit, speedily put down the revolts of heresies. Receive us all in your kingdom, declaring us children of the light, children of the day. Lord our God, give us your peace and your love.
And grant that with one voice and one heart may glorify and praise your most exalted and majestic name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, now and forever and unto the ages of ages.
Amen.
And may the mercies of our great God and Savior Jesus Christ be with all of you.
And with your spirit.
Having remembered all the saints, let us again in peace pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
And consecrated, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
But our loving God, having accepted them in his holy, mystical altar in heaven, as an offering of spiritual fragrance, may in return send upon us divine grace and the gift of the Holy Spirit, let us pray.
Lord, have mercy.
Have mercy upon us and protect us, O God, by your grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Ημέραν πάσαν τέλειαν, αγίαν, ειρηνικήν και αμάρτητον παρά του Κυρίου ετήσωμεθα.
Πάντα σου, Κύριε.
Ειρηνής πιστών οδηγών, φύλακα των ψυχών και των σωμάτων ημών παρά του Κυρίου ετήσωμεθα.
Πάντα σου, Κύριε.
Συγγνώμη και άφεση των αμαρτιών και των πλημελημάτων ημών παρά του Κυρίου ετήσωμεθα.
Πάντα σου, Κύριε.
Καλά και συμφέροντα τες ψυχές ημών και ειρήνη το κόσμο παρά του Κυρίου ετήσωμεθα.
Παρά σου, Κύριε.
Τον υπόλοιπον χρόνο της ζωής ημών εν ειρήνη και μετάνοια εκτελέσε παρά του Κυρίου ετήσωμεθα.
Παρά σου, Κύριε.
Ανώδυναν απέσχυντα ειρηνικά και καλήν απολογίαν την επί του φοβερού βήματος του Χριστού ετήσωμεθα.
Παρά σου, Κύριε.
Την ενότητα της πίστεως και την κοινωνία του Άγιου Πνεύματος ετήσαμενη εαυτούς και αλλήλους και πάσαν την ζωή ημών Χριστό το Θεό παράθωμεθα.
Συ, Κύριε.
Αξίωσον ημάς δέσποτα μετά παρησίας, ακατακρίτως του μ' επικαλείστε σε τον επουράνιον Θεόν, Πατέρα και λέγει.
Πάτερ ημών, ο εν της ουρανής, Άγιος γη το όνομά Σου, εφέτη η Βασιλεία Σου, γεννηθείτε το θέλημά Σου, ως εν ουρανό και επί της γης, των άτων ημών των πλούσιων, δώσε μην σήμερον, και άφησε μην τα αφλήματα ημών, ως και εμείς εν φύντε φλέτες ημών, και εμείς εν έγξη μας πειρασμών, αλλά ρίσε μας από το πονηρού. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
For yours is the kingdom and the power and the glory of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and unto the ages of ages.
Amen.
Give me paz and peace be with all.
And to your spirit.
Let us bow our heads unto the Lord.
To you, O Lord. Son of God,
Of men. The chief priests and the rulers at the time, after Christ was placed in the tomb, went to Pilate asking for a battalion of soldiers to secure the tomb, because they remember what he spoke and what he preached while he was still alive. And in 3 days I will rise from the dead. And so Pilate gave them a battalion of soldiers, sent them off. They sealed the tomb. They made it secure. They set a group of soldiers to watch throughout the night and the day. They knew not. Those in Hades were waiting. Those in Hades had heard the words from the forerunner John. Prepare the way of the Lord. They had seen Lazarus taken from their midst. And now, Hades receives the soul of Christ, thinking that it is receiving the soul of a man, only to realize that it has accepted God into its place. God, the creator of the universe, the uncontainable God, the icon of the resurrection shows it so beautifully. There are no words for me to be able to explain, to be able to describe the power of God. See how the gates are tossed asunder. See how the chains are broken. See how the locks are opened. And understand and believe that those who have died now live. Those who were held captive by death now live freely with God. Death no longer reigns supreme. Death no longer is an end. Death now becomes a new beginning, a new birth with our Lord in paradise. Arise, O God, and judge the earth. Arise, so that we may live. Arise, so that we may worship you. Arise, so that we may glorify you with untired voices and echo the hymns of the heavenly chorus of angels, glorifying you tirelessly until the ages of ages. Those who have died are now free. are living. We await the cry of command. We await the sound of the trumpet of God. We await to hear that cry of victory, to lift up our voices and chant the victory hymn of Christos Anesti. We await in heightened anticipation, not knowing fully what to expect, but understanding with all of our being that nothing that surrounds us in this world, nothing that seems to take up every moment of our life of care and of worry, means anything. We are called now to attention. We are called to preparation. In a few moments, we will come forward to receive the body and blood of Christ. We will feel empowered by this great gift of the sacrament of Holy Eucharist. We will be emboldened to be able to take this opportunity of this great and holy Saturday to prepare ourselves to gather back in the church, back together with the entire battalion of faith, and to offer ourselves and to celebrate with the universe Christ's victory over death and the reopening of paradise. Amen. As you come forward to receive Holy Communion, I remind you to please speak loudly and say your baptismal name loudly. And also, please be careful, as the symbols of victory, the bay leaves, are quite slippery when placed on marble.
Εξηγήθηκος ύπνον Κύριος και ανέστη σώζον ημάς. Αλληλούια.
Σαντα αποδόσεις αυτού τον Εύη λατρεύοντα πάσα στα σαν ομοία σου τον Υιόμενον πάσα στα νόσου σου τον λυτρούμενον εκθωράς την ζωήν σου τον στεφανούντας εν ελέη και ικτυρμής, τον επιπλώντας.
αγαθείς την επιθυμίαν σου, ανακαινισθήσετε όσα ετού είναι ότι σου. Ποιον ελεημοσύνας ο Κύριος και κρίμα πάση της αδικουμένης εγνώρισε τα σοδούς αυτού το Μωυσή της εις Ισραήλ τα θελήματα αυτού. Ικτήρμον και ελεήμον ο Κύριος, μακρόθυμος και πολυέλεος, ουκ εις τέλος οργισθήσετε, ουδέ εις τον αιώνα μηνύ. Ο κατάτας ανομίας ημών επίσεν ημίν, ουδέ κατάτας αμαρτίας ημών ανταπέδωκεν ημίν. Ότι κατά το ύψος του ουρανού από της γης εκρατέωσε Κύριος το έλεος αυτού επί τους φοβουμένους αυτών, καθώς ον απέχουσιν ανατολέα ποδισμών, εμάκρινεν αφημών τας ανομίας ημών. Καθώς ικτήρι πατήριους, ο κτήρισε Κύριος τους φοβουμένους αυτών, ότι αυτός έγνωτο πλάσμα ημών, εμνηστεί ότι χούσες μεν. Άνθρωπος, όσοι χόρτωσε η μέρη αυτού, όσοι άντος του αγρού, ούτως εξανθήσει, ότι πνεύμα δίωθεν εν αυτό και ουκ υπάρξει και ουκ επιγνώσετε έτη των τόπων αυτού. Το δε έλεος του Κυρίου από του του αιώνος επί τους φοβουμένους αυτών και η δικαιοσύνη αυτού επί ίσιον της φιλόσουση την διαθήκη αυτού και με μνημένη στον εντολό σε αυτάς. Κύριος, εν το ουρανό ετοίμασε τον θρόνον αυτού και η βασιλεία αυτού πάντων δεσπόζει. Ευλογείτε τον Κύριον πάντες οι άγγελοι αυτού, δυνατοί σκυπιούντες των λόγων αυτού, του ακούσε τις φωνής των λόγων αυτού. Ευλογείτε τον Κύριον πάσε δυνάμει
αυτού, λειτουργία αυτού υπηούντες το θέλημα αυτού. Ευλογείτε τον Κύριον πάντα τα έργα αυτού, εν πάντη τόπο της δεσποτείας αυτού, ευλόγη η ψυχή μου τον Κύριον. Δόξα Πατρί
και πολύ πάνω αυτό λύτρωσης και αυτός λύτρωσεται τον Ισραήλ εκ πασών των ανομιών αυτού. Σήμερον αδιστένον βαρ συνεφερέ τον εκ Μαρίας γεννηθέντα, μη υπεδεξάμι, εθόν γάρεπε με, το κράτος μου έλυσε, πύλας χακάς συνέτριψε. Ψυχά σας κατήχων των πριν Θεός ον ανέστησε. Δόξα Κύριε το Σταυρό όσο και τη Αναστάσεις.
But for the Lord is steadfast with love, and him is for redemption, and he will redeem Israel from all his iniquities. Today, Hades, let outtake Rome. Would that I not receive the Son of Mary. For when he came upon me, he dissolved my power. He shattered the gates of bronze, the souls I had held. has God he raised up. Glory, Lord, to your cross and your resurrection.
Ενείτε τον Κύριον πάντα τα έθνη, επενέσατε αυτόν πάντες οι λαοί. Σήμερον ο Άδης στένων βοάν κατελήθη μου η εξουσία, έδεξα ως περαινατών θανόντων, τούτων δε κατέχειν όλος ους ισχύω, αλλά πόλο μετά τούτων ον εβασί. Κύριε, το σταυρό σου και τη ανάστασή σου.
Praise the Lord, all you nations, exalt him, all you peoples. Today, Hades, let out a groan. My sovereignty is destroyed. I received him as a mortal, one among the dead, but this one I am powerless to contain. Instead, with him, I lose all I had governed. I had held the dead for ages, but behold, he resurrects all. Glory, Lord, to your cross and your resurrection.
Ότι εκρατεώθη το έλεος αυτού εφημάς και η αλήθεια του Κυρίου μένει εις τον αιώνα. Σήμερον ο Άδης στένων βοά κατεπόρθη μου το κράτος, όπι μήνε σταυρό και τον Αδάμ ανέστησε. Ον πέρε βασίλευον έστε χρήμα μη και ους κατεπιόν ισχύσας πάνος εξή μέσα. Thank you.
Χριστός Ιησού.
For mighty is his love for us, and the truth of the Lord endures forever. Today, Hades lets out a groan. My mind is swallowed up. The shepherd was crucified, but raised up at all. All I have ruled over, I have lost. All I was able in my power to consume, I have disgorged. The crucified one has emptied the graves. The sway of death is no more. Glory, Lord, to your cross and your resurrection.
Yeah.
this truly is the blessed Sabbath. This is truly
Yeah.
Yeah. εμνημόνευσας του ληστού εν η βασιλεία των ουρανών.
Και το Υιό και το Άγιο Πνεύμα την ίν και αΐ και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων.
Αμήν.
Προέλθομεν του Κυρίου δεήθομεν.
Κύριε λέησον, Κύριε λέησον, Πάτερ Άγιε ευλογήσον.
Lord, bless those who praise you and sanctify those who trust in you. Save your people and bless your inheritance. Protect the whole body of your church. Sanctify those who love the beauty of your house. Glorify them and return by your divine power. Do not forsake us who put our hope in you. Grant peace to your world, to your churches, to the clergy, to those in public service, to our armed forces, and to all your people. For every good and perfect gift is from above, coming from you, the Father of lights. And to you we give glory, thanksgiving, and worship. To the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and unto the ages of ages.
Amen. Ή το όνομα Κυρίου ευλογημένον από του νυν και ως του αιώνος. Ή το όνομα Κυρίου ευλογημένον από του νυν και ως του αιώνος. Ή το όνομα Κυρίου ευλογημένον από του νυν και ως του αιώνος.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
The Lord and his mercy come upon you through his divine grace and love always now and forever and unto the ages of ages.
Amen.
Δόξα σοι ο Θεός ελπίσιμον, Κύριε δόξα σοι, ο Αναστάς εκ νεκρών Χριστός, ο αληθινός Θεός ημών, της πρεσβείας της Παναχράντου και Παναμόμου, Αγίας Αυτομητρός, δυνάμει το τιμίου Κουσοποιού Σταυρού, προστασίας το τιμίου των ουρανίων δυνάμεων σωμάτων, ηκεσίας του μείον δόξου προφήτου βοδόμου του Ιωάννου, των Ιωάννου δόξου δίπνων Αποστόλων, των Ιωάννου δόξου νοικοματήριων, των Ιωάννου και Θεοφόρων Πατέρων ημών, τον Αγίον και Δικαίωθο Πατρών Ιωκήμ και Άνης, Βαρβάρος Πεγλωμάτριος και πάντων τον Αγίον, λέησε και σώσει μας αγαθός και φιλάνθρωπος και λέει μόνος Θεός. Διευκόν τον Αγίον Πατέρων ημών, Κύριε Ιησού Χριστέ ο Θεός, ελέησον και σώσον ημάς.
Αμήν.
May the grace of our Lord God and Savior Jesus Christ be with all of us forever.
Once again, good morning. And thank you for coming together and celebrating this most beautiful service. I pray that our Lord gives us strength throughout the course of this day so that we may once again gather beginning at 11 o'clock this evening or perhaps tomorrow in the morning at 11 o'clock for those of us who are unable to come this evening as well, so that we too may celebrate with those who have already been freed and those who continue to live. Thanks, Gideon. Have a wonderful day.
context, looking for